How's it going, everyone? I'm Scott Moss, and welcome to Intro to Next.js V2. Next.js is a framework that has caught my attention like none other. It has allowed me to be more productive than any other framework that I've ever used. In this course, we're gonna cover everything from getting started with Next.js using the CLI Create Next app, all the way to taking advantage of some of the newer features introduced to the React ecosystem, like server components and client components, and how and when to use them. Believe me when I say I had a blast creating this course, so I hope you have just as much fun taking it. Now, this is a heavily requested feature from Next.js. I know I've been dying to get something like this since I've been using Next.js, and it's exactly what it sounds like. It's a layout, right? A layout is basically, you know, take some common UI that you want a bunch of pages to have and share, and you know, you can create a component that abstracts that UI out, and then you can embed the pages into it so it kind of wraps it. So you could think of this as like a nav bar, a sidebar, and a footer. That's going on all my pages. So I'm gonna put that in a layout, and then it's gonna wrap everything else. So they all have those elements around it. In V12 of Next.js, there is no framework specific way to do this. If you go look at the documentation for V12, they have like three different ways they recommend that you do it, but it's still on you to figure that out. And there's still like the biggest caveat with all those approaches is that you can't get data in the layout, which is just, it hurts because a lot of, like, think of a layout where, I don't know, you have a sidebar and it's got like the user's picture and their name. Okay, you got to get that from somewhere, but the layout can't get data at server time on Next.12. So you have to either get it client side, which introduces more issues and things like that. Well, I'm glad to say that layouts are now fully supported first party with Next.js. All you have to do is just make a layout file. Layout.tsx is the name of the file that you have to make on any given level, and all the pages on that level and underneath it will have that layout, right? So let's give it a shot. So in this layout, I'm going to, I don't know, put something here that says layout, right? And then I'm going to render the children here. So let's put that in a div like that, okay? So now every page that I go to, because layout is, this layout here is on the root, we should see layout, right? So let's see. Oh, there it is. There's layout. It's right there. If I go to slash contact, there's layout. It's still there. Blog. I've never made a page for blog, so that's never going to show up. But for slug, there it is. It's still there. That's the layout. It's going to be a layout for all the pages and all the children underneath it, which if you've thought about it a little more, you could do nested layout, which is really cool, right? So what does that look like? Well, if I go into my contact here in this folder and I make a layout.tsx, right? And then I can do something like export default function contact layouts. Like this, and I can say return this div, need to grab the children. Because it's a layout, you have to always remember to embed the children, because the children are the things that's being stuck into, these are the pages or the layouts, because it could be a page or a layout going into another layout because they're nested. If you don't have that, it'll just be the layout itself and you will never see your content. So be sure to have that, and then you can just say like contact layout. All right, and then we can say, let's do something like that, children, like that. So now if we do that, so we go to contact. You can see here's the outer layout, here's the contact layout, and then here's the actual contact page. All right, so it can nest forever. So it's actually quite powerful. API that I always like to hit is Reddit. So if we go to reddit.com/.json, right? If you go there, you get Reddit as JSON. I don't know if anybody knew that, but you can just do that without an API key. It's pretty cool. So I'm gonna grab this URL. And I want to access that data in this home component, because maybe I want to put this stuff on my home page, right? So before server components, I would have to make a route in our APIs, which we'll talk about eventually. And then that route will make a call to Reddit, and then it'll return the data, and then I'll get the data back from our API, and then I can put it on the page. That's one approach. The second approach is I would just call Reddit from the client after it boots up and use like a hook, and then you know when it in a use effect, I'll put it in there, and then it'll get Reddit, and then I'll load it in, and I'll set the loading state and do all this weird stuff. Those are the two ways you can do it, both of which are costly as far as the runtime. But the server component, I can just do it directly in here. So what I'll do is I'll go to the server component, and the convention that I see people starting to do is they'll make a function called like getData in their server component. And then getData is just going to be like some async thing. And then in our case, I'm just going to say data equals await, and I can just call fetch like this. I can pass it this URL. And it works very much like window.fetch. In fact, it is exactly like window.fetch, just enhanced. So we can fetch, and we can do things like configuring the cache. But we'll talk about that stuff in a little bit. So we got the data, and I'm just going to return data.json. All right, so now we got the data. And then check it. I can do this. Or if I can spell it right, I can make this component async. Now, this is something you cannot do in a React client component. In fact, you've never been able to do this in React ever, right? This won't work. If I change this to a client component, this will break, because React components aren't functions. They're components with life cycles that run over and over and over again. This is why you have to have a hook, because if you don't, when the component re-renders, any variable that you were trying to keep track of resets because the function runs again. So you need a hook to tell React, hey, don't lose track of this variable for me across re-renders. Well, this thing doesn't have re-renders. It just happens once on the server, and then it gets cached, depending on your revalidation strategy. So I can async this, and then now I can say, hey, you know what? Block, don't render any of this JSX yet until I get the Reddit data. So I can do that now. So this will block the rendering of the page until this comes back. And then I can get the data, and I can just do whatever I want here. Let's look at the data, though, so I can actually do something with it. So we got data.data.children.data. So let's get like one of the first ones. So we'll say a post is data.data.children0.data. And then is there a title on here? There's got to be a title on here somewhere. Name. Nope. There it is, title. I knew it. Okay. Cool. So we got the post, and then I can just go down here and just say, let's put that here. Post. There we go. If it all works, we should see a title here. If it all works. So let's see what happens. Let's go back here. Oh, it's already there. I didn't even refresh. It's already there. So because it happened on the server, right? This didn't happen and on the client side. This page doesn't even show up until it renders. In fact, you can't, if you look like just a little, will it zoom in if I do this? Let me see. Oh yeah, if you just look right here, when I refresh it, it actually does take a little longer. See that? That was it fetching the Reddit data, right? If I didn't have that, it wouldn't take that long. It would have happened immediately, right? And I can really exaggerate this by like putting a set time out here for 10 seconds just so like we can actually see it, but I think y'all get the point. It's not going to render anything here until it gets the data, which to me makes way more sense than the way we do it now in client components with like hooks and like trying to figure out the order of which things are rendering. It's like, why can't I just wait till I get some data back before I render this stuff versus doing like an if statement and like, if the data is not there, then do this and this use effect, right? To me, mentally, it makes more sense. It works the way you think any function would ever work. It won't move forward unless this is done, just like any function ever works. So that's because it's server side and it's opting out of the React reconciliation phases and things like that. Whereas client side is business as usual. It's not going to work this way on the client side. And this is why it's very important to know if you're in a client component or not, right? If, as soon as I add this, you can forget about it, right? We're done. It's not going to work. Just you can't, I don't even know what error it's going to throw at this point. Oh yeah, right here. Promise? You can't put a promise in the right there. Render a collection of children. You can't do that because we're in the client side and you can't do that. So big difference there. And you're not limited in scope of what you do here. So we talked about fetch.
and how it works. And I talked about being able to extend it, the caching. We'll talk about that a little deeper, because that's just coarse by itself, is like caching with fetch. But you're not limited to just only doing fetch. You can do whatever you want inside of an async component. So for instance, if you're getting something without fetch, like a database call or an SDK, you can put that in here. There's nothing stopping you. If you had Stripe, you can use Stripe in here. If you had, you know, Prisma, and you were doing some Prisma stuff in here, you could do that in here. There's literally nothing stopping you. Anything you do on the server side, you can do in here. Let's do this contact form here. So for the contact form, we're going to have to do a mutation because it's a form. So we have to post somewhere. So we're going to have to make an API that receives some input to post to, so we can create that form and we can record people contacting us, right? So let's do that. So inside of our pages directory, I'm actually just going to delete. I'm in pages/API. I'm going to delete this stuff because we don't need it. And I'm going to make pages/API/contact.ts. I'm just going to export default handler like that. Nope. Why did it do that? What was that? I need function. There we go. And it takes a request and a response. And then I'll just say if request.method triple equals post, it's all caps, then let's go to work. So then I'll say, cool. You know, this is where you would save to DB. We don't have a DB, so we're not going to save it to DB. We're just posting to our server. So I'm just going to respond by to let them know that, gotcha. So I'll say, res.json, message. OK, we got it. Thank you. All right. So we are good there. And then inside of our contact form, let's make that. We'll just say const or export default function contact return. Oh, but wait, if we have to do mutation, how do we do that in a server component?
You don't.
Oh, we don't. So what do we do with this component?
Use client at the top and then.
So turn the whole page into a client component like this?
Could you do router refresh?
If we needed to list the thing that you just submitted, yeah. But are you suggesting we turn the whole page into a client component?
You could probably actually maybe put that in like the button itself.
Yeah, you could just do it in the part that's doing the interaction. There's no wrong or right, but it is ideal to try to squeeze the client all the way down to the part that's actually doing the client thing, versus making the whole page suffer and have them be client. So I just wanted you to think about that exercise, that thought exercise. But yeah, we'll just turn the whole page to a client because it's faster. But yeah, you probably don't want to do that in production. So we'll just say, cool. Now, this is just the stuff you already know. Guess what? You can do this thing. You remember this? Ho ho, look at that. You remember that? It's still there. How's that feel? Yeah, all right, okay. So we got that. Looks good, right? Give me your email. Actually, it'll just be a string. We don't need that. Cool. Cool, we got that. And it's just a form in here, right? So form on submit. It's gonna handle submit, which is going to do some thing eventually. We'll get to that thing. And then got that in there. And then we just have an inputs for your email. That's required. And its value is email. And on change, it's going to just do this. Set email to e.target.value. Cool. So we got that. And then we need a button. That's type submit. Says submit. All right. I always need to do this. Need to prevent that form from refreshing, which honestly, this should just be by, this should just be standard. And then we can do whatever we need to do to for our API call here. So I'll make this async. And then we'll just say, you know, fetch. Which in this case will just be our URL slash API slash contact. So I can say slash API slash contact. Wait, can you do relative pass and fetch? I don't think you can. We're about to find out. So we'll do that. And then we'll say method post, you know, you post up the body, you got to stringify it, all this stuff, email, that type of thing. I think you also got to set the headers if you're doing JSON. Content type. Application, JSON, and then accept that. Okay. All right. Cool. So now we got that. We got our email. Got it. Oops. Got that. All right. So let's try our contact form. So if we go back home. And let's just put, did I put a log in the API? I didn't. Let's do that. Let's log the body there. All right. I misspelled value. Gotta love it. Okay, let's do that again. Hello, and there we go. Submitted our form. All right, so other than this looking really bad, we just made our own full stack landing page resume in like 20 minutes, right? Like if you had Tailwind, this would have been even faster. It would have been crazy.